These Italian flatbread pizzas are so unbelievably amazing that I always forget that they're also really healthy. And they're fun because everyone can put on their own toppings. This recipe makes four flatbread pizzas. The ingredients are four flatbreads, fresh mozzarella cheese, fresh grated Parmesan, basil, arugula, grape tomatoes, red onion, garlic cloves, olive oil, salt and pepper, and two large boneless, skinless chicken breasts. I want to mention that when I couldn't find arugula one time, I bought this spring mix because it said on the back that it had arugula. But when I tasted a leaf of it, it just tastes like plain lettuce. The only way that I can get arugula at my regular grocery store is in this mix of spinach and baby arugula. It tastes like an herb and not like plain lettuce. It's totally different, and it's a flavor that makes a big difference on this flatbread. But first, I want to thank Hardcore Italians for sending me this apron. I absolutely love it. If any of you want to check out their site, the link is below. Let's go. First, preheat your oven to 450 degrees. Okay, cut a red onion in half and then slice very thinly, like this right here. Then peel the equivalent of two large cloves of garlic or one large and two medium. This is for the pesto, so it's totally up to you how much garlic you like. Now wash and pat dry two large chicken breasts, or enough to cut at least 5 2-inch chunks for each pizza. We're going to cut them smaller after they're cooked. And cut 20 grape tomatoes in half, 5 for each flatbread pizza. Grate 1/2 cup Parmesan cheese for the pesto. Put 2 cups of fresh basil leaves, no stems, in a colander. Rinse well and pat dry with paper towels. Make sure that you get them really dry so that your pesto isn't watery. Put the 2 cups of basil leaves and 2 large cloves in a food processor and process until smooth. Now scrape down the sides and add the 1/2 cup of your finely shredded Parmesan cheese and 1/2 cup of olive oil. Process till smooth and you have an amazing pesto. Start heating a large skillet over medium-low, and while that's heating up, we can slice our mozzarella cheese. Cut into 4 1/2-inch slices to break up later. Add 1 tablespoon of olive oil to your hot skillet, add the sliced onions, and stir and flip until caramelized. Then remove to a bowl. Add 1 tablespoon of oil to the same pan, and add the chicken chunks, spreading them out evenly in the oil. Sprinkle with about 1 teaspoon of salt and about 1/8 teaspoon of fine pepper. Now here's my secret to cooking juicy but fully cooked chicken. Cover the skillet and then flip the chicken every minute or so for each side, but don't brown. Keep the lid on, and when they look like they're no longer pink, cut the largest one in half and check to make sure it is no longer pink inside. Then put the lid back on and remove from the burner. Let it rest while you line up your ingredients in order. Just look how juicy and tender these pieces of chicken are. Okay, here's the fun part to assemble your pizzas. Take each flatbread and spread with about 1/2 teaspoon of olive oil. The trick is to put the oil on the high parts and then let it run into the crevices. Then spoon the chicken pieces on and place it around so that you make sure you get a taste of chicken in every bite. If you like caramelized onions, then place a few strands around thinly and evenly. And now we're going to top with each of the thick slices of fresh mozzarella cheese, breaking it into chunks and placing them in all of the gaps. Then place the sliced grape tomatoes on top, half up, half down, or on their sides for nice presentation and varying flavors. Place them directly on the top rack of a 450 degree oven and then just bake until the cheese is melted, approximately 8 minutes. Then add a little bit of your fresh pesto around, and this smells so legit Italian. And then when you top them with several leaves of the fragrant baby arugula, the combination of these flavors in this flatbread pizza is so incredible that you'll be making it over and over again like I do. And some people even like it with the balsamic reduction glaze on the arugula. So delizioso.